Sure thing.
Thank you.
Saul's a good kid.
Hmm? What's that?
Saul was a good kid. I like him. It was nice him coming by.
Yeah? That's good to hear. Never met anyone with so much promise.
Never?
In my entire life. Saul's dad was a good man. Didn't think his kid had it. As a boy, he was too soft. But then he got older, graduated college, really came into his own. Eager. More capable than he knows.
Great listener.
Can you believe we were his age once?
Hard to admit.
When I was young, I thought I knew everything.
Yeah? And now?
Today I learned from you and him about chestnuts.
Well, I learn something new every day, I suppose. You check the spark plugs?
Give me a second. What about your boy?
Bill? Oh, he's fine, I guess.
You guess? Hey, how old is he again?
Born in 60, so, 32 as of September.
Huh.
Dead navigator from the Korean War came to him in a dream, said the planes were in danger of being lost, and it was up to Chuck to save them.
So, Chuck's crazy.
Well, eccentric maybe, but, well. Do you believe in ghosts?
If I did, I'd have a different job. Why, do you?
I figure we all move on in some way. Energy is neither created nor lost and all that.
So you're saying a dead navigator came to a farmer in the middle of nowhere, no offense, and told him that it was his job to preserve airplanes?
Yep.
So now there's a bunch of planes on a crazy coot's farm.
And he keeps them safe. Can you think of a better place for him to be?
Well, want to try running it?
Nah, I trust you.
Well, suit yourself. Where to next? Shotguns, huh?
I always liked shotguns.
Liked?
Still do.
I like revolvers myself, when it's for sport.
Those?
Oh, yeah? Favorite.
Them big slab-sided ones. They have a charisma. What about you?
Oh, nothing special, really. 357s when I can. But this is a shotgun.
Yep. Figured we could shoot some skeet. Always liked shooting skeet. Taught Bill to shoot this way.
You're a good father.
Couldn't have been better.
Name a father I couldn't. So, how do we do this?
I'll go first.
All right, then. This is more my speed. Shooting guns. Maybe a few beers in there.
I'm not sure guns and beers mix, friend.
Oh, sure they do. Like peanut butter and very dangerous chocolate. Next time. Trust me, next time.
There isn't gonna be a next time.
Oh, there's always a next time.
This is it. After today, we are done.
I'm trying to tell you, there is no out. There is no done. You keep doing this. You never do anything again. It's permanent. Kaput.
And it's kaput.
You don't mean it.
If that's the way it's gotta be.
You have a choice.
You haven't listened to a word I've said.
I've been listening. I've been listening all morning. I've been listening to you talk about being sad and lonely and refusing to listen to reason.
I have my reasons.
Your reasons aren't any good.
But they're mine.
Walk me to my car. So, this is it then?
It is.
Why? Why are you doing this?
Because I need to.
We're friends, goddammit. You don't get to get all stoic on me. I know losing her was hard, but there's gotta be something. Gotta be.
I can't take care of the farm like I used to. There isn't much point anymore.
So sell the farm. Move into the city. Meet someone new.
Do you believe in hell?
What?
Do you believe in hell?
I'm not scared of hell, if that's what you mean.
I didn't ask if you were scared. I asked if you believe.
I don't know.
Well, I do. And I think doing this, I think that's where I'm headed.
And why? You think you can buy your way into heaven?
I can't take back what I've done. What I can do is do something right.
Why?
Because I want to see her again. That's all. I just want to see her again. And I figure I'll do one right thing with my life, just one thing. Maybe I'll get to see her again. One more time.
And this is your one right thing?
It is.
You know? How do you know if any of this is true?
I don't know. But I got the notion, and the notion's got me. So, least I can do is tell you adios.
Just like that?
What else is there to say?
Not much, I guess.
No.
All right, then. Have it your way. I'll be back this evening. You get an afternoon. Do whatever you gotta do. Just, leave the door unlocked.
I can do that.
Adios, friendo.
Be seeing ya.
Come on now. That's a good boy. Brung you an apple. Granny Smith, just like you like. Good boy. Good boy. You've been real good to me. You know that? Mm-hmm. Brought me a lot of good luck. Good times. Without you, my
to thank you. I want to thank you for all you done. Gonna go ahead and leave the barn door open behind me when I go. You want to leave, you go find someone else. I figure I'll just, I'll leave you to it.
Nice catch.
Come on.
Nice catch. Nice catch.
Come on.
Oh, do not do that.
Nice catch.
Hey, Edie, it's...
Oh, hey, you. How are you doing? You know, I was just talking about you with Garth the other day. I said, Garth, you know, we ought to visit.
Edie, listen, I don't mean to interrupt. It's just, I'm on a tight schedule, and I need you to do me a favor, all right?
A favor? Sure. What you need?
I'm going to be out of town for a few days.
Oh? Finally taking my advice and visiting family?
I was wondering if you and Garth could make sure the animals were fed and watered, you know, that kind of thing.
Oh, sure, sure. We ain't got much going on.
Thanks, Edie. Listen,
Evan! Evan! What are you doing? Get down from there. Sorry, cats. Anyway, what were you saying?
Yeah, the animals. I got them fed and watered for today. They should be good for tomorrow, too. But if it's too much of an imposition...
Not at all. Not at all. We're happy to be imposed upon. You've been a good neighbor for so long. I'm glad you called me today. In fact, just the other day, I said to Garth, I said, if we don't visit, then we should host. Reach out. Say hello. Put together a little neighborly get-together. And you know what he said? He said... Well, Edie, if we did that, we'd just... Oh, you know what? Let me go get him for you.
Thank you, Edie.
Hey, you should drop on by next Saturday afternoon. We're going out to the Harvest Festival with the grandkids, and I know how lonely it's been, what with Sadie gone and all. You should come with.
Oh, I appreciate the thought, Edie. I don't think I'll be back in town by then, though. Sorry.
Oh, that's too bad. It's been real nice seeing you coming back to church again.
Oh, it's been real nice being welcomed back. But now I gotta go. You know, chores and such. You know how it is.
Oh, I sure do. Well, come on over sometime. Just got some gooseberries in. We're making pies, and we'd love to have you. I know they're your favorite.
That they are. Gotta go now.
See ya.
Dad?
Bill, I... Well, now how'd you know it was me?
Caller ID.
I don't know what that is.
It's new. Tells me who's calling.
Huh, that's some real fancy stuff you got there.
Uh-huh. Listen, I'm busy. Why are you calling?
Hadn't talked in a while.
And whose fault is that?
Can't we talk?
What is there to say? Hi, son. How are the grandkids?
How are they?
Oh, by the way, I put your mom in a rest home so I could stay there and take care of my goats and my pigs and my stupid horse. Because, God forbid, I actually look after my sick wife.
That's not fair.
You put her in a home. You decided she wasn't good enough for you, and you put her in a home.
I didn't know what to do. The doctors there, they would.
How hard could it be? Alzheimer's isn't some terrifying boogeyman. It wasn't it you who told me to stay with the ones you love, no matter what? So what? You didn't love her anymore?
Don't you dare.
You gave her up. You gave her up to doctors and nurses. You know what they do to people in homes.
It was the best home money could buy.
Money. You and your damn money cared more about being a rich pig farmer than the people you were supposed to love.
Hey, I loved you both. I did everything for you, everything.
Yeah, right.
Bill, I didn't want this call to...
You wanted to put my mom in a home, so I'm not sure what you want matters.
Bill, I just called to say...
Say what? Sorry? Did you know I visited her? I found out where you put her, and I visited her. They said you visited sometimes.
She was my wife, Bill.
She cried, Dad. She cried. She wept and she sobbed and she kept asking me where you were. She was so scared, Dad. She was so scared. She wanted you to take her home.
The doctor said sometimes she was lucid, but I couldn't.
She was lucid, Dad. And I held her hand as she sobbed herself to sleep. And I kept holding her hand until they told me I had to go. Where were you? Taking care of your precious chestnuts? Feeding your heritage breed pigs?
No, Bill, I...
Save it. Talk to your goats or your pigs or whatever it is you do.
I just wanted to tell you... Goodbye, Bill. I've got some of your stuff all boxed up. If you wouldn't mind coming by in a few days to pick it up.
We'll see.
Goodbye, son.
You'll never make this right, Dad.
I'm still trying.